It's a capital C of red here in Washington. And tonight's game is available on TSN HD and in 5.1 Dolby Digital Surround Sound. TSN, Canada's sports leader in high definition. The starting goaltenders are brought to you by Tim Hortons. Proud to support Timbits Minor Hockey, where the first goal is having fun. Gentlemen in the studio mentioned that Marty Perron is making his Stanley Cup playoff debut, and he brings a shutout streak of 121 minutes and 34 seconds into this game. At the other end, it's Cristobal Huye, who won his last nine starts, a 1.52 goals against average and 11 and 2 since coming over from Montreal to Washington. Well, it's been billed as Cinderella against the Bullies. Glenn Healy perched between the benches. What are you looking for?
First of all, the energy in the building, it's exceptional. Both these teams have watched other teams play in the playoff for 2 days. So both teams are extremely ready to play. It should be an exciting game and a great start.
Almost a week of preparations. Matt Cook starts things off with a big-time jolt, and the puck now is sent into Philadelphia territory. Jason Smith, the captain, returning to the Flyer lineup after missing the last game of the regular season and a couple of practices with a sore right shoulder that the Capitals will try and test. Sergei Fedorov starting up front for Washington, and now he'll peel back, and over the boards comes Alexander Ovechkin, number 8, along with Nick Backstrom and Viktor Kozlov, as Ovechkin makes his Stanley Cup playoff debut with a pass through center past Upshaw down the ice. The Flyers get on it first, so there's no icing. Upshaw a shot that's off target and out of play off the screen, 61 seconds in.
Bob McKenzie mentioned 24 rookies Stanley Cup playoff. Ovechkin's one of them. $10 million player's got to go under the garbage bin to get the ball. He sees himself on TV. You tell me this guy's nervous. Hey, there's me. Look at him waving. And his competitive nature, even in the game of soccer. I don't see nerves in him. I see readiness and preparation.
Bruce Boudreau suggested at 5 o'clock today he might be the most nervous of the Washington Capitals. Most of the Caps, even though they do not have Stanley Cup experience, were part of Bruce Boudreau's Calder Cup team a couple of years ago that won the championship. And the first penalty of the game is going against Philadelphia. Brad Watson and Wes McCauley in charge of this game. Shane Heyer, Steve Barton on the lines.
Well, you cannot do that. Simple play. Kozlov's not in the scoring area. You want to take away time and space and puck possession for these guys, because they'll get the puck to 8 sooner or later. But the number one most penalized team in the East can't put this collection of stars to the power play.
Alexander Semin lined up out of your screen as a wide winger to the left side, but puck comes back into the Washington zone.
Chris, might as well be 5 forwards out here. Green does everything that a forward would do. 18 goals, so you've got a lot of firepower on the ice.
Leading goal scorer and point getter in the National Hockey League in Ovechkin, and the leading goal scorer among NHL defensemen in Mike Green, who bluffs it down at the right point. He's jolted there, and a neat play by R.J. Umberger to kick that puck back into Washington ice. Well, the Calgary product, Green, to the red line, will send it in. Puck around, Nick Backstrom goes after it. Now Ovechkin knocks it down at the line. Richards breaks it up, and Mike Richards is back. 5 shorthanded goals during the regular season, and it's knocked out of his skates into the corner. Patrick Thorsen also on the penalty kill, the former Edmonton Oiler, who's been a good pickup for the Philadelphia Flyers. Now to work comes Semin. He takes a hot shot high. Thomas Fleischmann now a leading goal scorer on that Calder Cup team a couple of years ago. It'll be Semin shooting off the side of the net. Fleischmann up with a rebound. Brooks Like is also up front now on the back half of this power play. Ovechkin a shot. And that was deflected off the sprawling Lassie Kukkonen wide. Like works behind the net. 8 power play goals on the year for Brooks Like. Green still at the right point. He'll slide it through, and now back for Ovechkin, who led the NHL with 22 power play goals. Into the slot, broke it up, and the Flyers will clear off the stick of Joffrey Lupul. Just a dozen seconds remaining in the penalty to Mike Knuble. Washington just 2-for-11 against the Flyers in the regular season series. Tom Pody with a pass in front, open net, scores! Donald Brashear, the former Flyer, an unlikely icebreaker for Washington.
Washington on the board first. The only guy they don't think they have to cover is Brashear, who rarely, if ever, scores. Makes his way to the front of the net for a captain punt. Nobody picks up Brashear. Not the start that Philadelphia wants. A bad penalty. And now this crowd that was electric before the Capitals stepped on the ice is even more charged up. This building is just full of energy.
Donald Brashear in his 50th Stanley Cup playoff game. Only Sergei Fedorov with more postseason experience for Washington. Brashear, 5 goals during the regular season, and he has the first Stanley Cup playoff goal for Washington since 2003. Brashear played 4 years with the Flyers, 270 games. As an enforcer with Philadelphia. And he scores early in this one. And now Vinny Prostman along with Daniel Briere up front. But the Capitals will play it back in placement in pursuit of the puck. Ryan Parrott to the lineup for the Flyers. It comes back to the point and the shot off the glove of Biron and a big rebound. Now Boyd Gordon is on it. He'll swing it in for Brooks Like. Loose at the side of the net. Like trying to center it. Thomas Fleischmann with a bit of a pick as the puck comes back to Pody. He'll try and get it deep, and that's broken up by Prostful. Checked by Fleischmann. Looks like is there. He goes to the boards with Parrott playing in his first Stanley Cup postseason game. In behind the net, Parrott tied up with Light. Matt Bradley steps into Parrott. And now out comes Scott Hartnell. Hartnell, the former Nashville Predator, looking for his first ever Stanley Cup series win. Lassie Kukkonen in his own zone. Kimmo Tiiminen and Donald Brashear back on the ice as Bruce Boudreau goes with the hot stick early, Glenn.
And he's played him all year and has put great faith in him in lots of situations. And that's the one thing about Bruce. He instills confidence in his players because if they make mistakes, he puts them back out.
And he'll put them out when Riley Cote's on the ice as well. Jim Dowd is out. R.J. Umberger, a surprise fourth liner. Huge hit there, Matt Bradley. Now Brashear and Cote eye each other. They went once in the 4 meetings this year, and they have a long discussion before Cote goes to the Flyer bench.
Brashear filled him in, though, Chris.
And now Brashear back to work offensively. Sliding it across in the slot. That's picked off and cleared. Brashear heads off. Backstrom's got it. Backstrom feeds to Kozlov. Brashear to the bench so Ovechkin can join his line mates. May not want to overstay his shift when Ovechkin's next up. And the puck sent back into the Washington zone. Good pace. And the Caps have to like the start. 5 minutes and 40 seconds in. Kukkonen drives it in. There's Steve Ehminger, who draws an assignment with the injury to Jeff Schultz. A centering pass back to the point. And now it's fed left point. Kimmo Tiiminen right on. Cristobal Huilé with his first stop of the night. Ovechkin to work. Looking to work in against Kukkonen. Now it's Kozlov along the boards. Got to work his way back. A shot knocked down. Backstrom's got it. Tracked by Richards. He will get the checking aside to Ovechkin. Had a chance there. Spinning and a backhand is blocked. As the puck bounced in the slot. And Ovechkin had a couple of whacks at it. Kukkonen up for Lupul. Funny hop off the stanchion and it's turned back. Here's Seven. Twisting into the zone. Passing it for Fedorov. Swooping around. Seven. Quick release and he just missed. Boy, Seven can get the shot away in a hurry. Mike Green's in and he shot it wide. Fedorov covering for Green at the right point. Back in deep. Matt Cook works the corner up against Carter. And Braden Coburn will relieve the pressure. Mike Green Green will lead them back in. Plus seven, Green was in the four meetings against Philadelphia. Alexander Semin tracked by Braden Coburn, who gets a piece of him. Fedorov with a hit on Carter. Sergei Fedorov with 163 Stanley Cup playoff points, and this is his 163rd game.
He came over from Carolina. A couple things he had to learn to do. First, he had to learn to play again, because this team actually played with a brain instead of some of the other teams in the league. And the second thing was he had to get in good enough shape to be able to play 20-plus minutes a game. He didn't get that responsibility in Columbus.
Here's Kleisman working in. Lights in front! To the pass was broken up there. Jason Smith with a big defensive play on the 2-on-1. Now Daniel Briere back to work, playing with a brace on a left knee that was injured late in the season, an MCL sprain. Washington sends it down the ice, and we will take a break. Donald Brashear, the goal scorer, and the Washington Capitals strike first.
Part of the reason for the great success in Washington this year, the emergence of Mike Green. Watch him carry the puck on the power play through mid-ice. Philadelphia, they're going to have to do a better job of not allowing this guy to carry the puck through mid-ice, because when he does, like there, it ends up in the back of your net. Here's an example of why he had 18 goals this season. And Ovechkin, just say OV. Yep, we're paying attention to you. Two shifts, 3:24 already in this hockey game that is 8 minutes old. One shot, three blocked shots, Chris Cuthbert. So four shots already. He is not afraid to shoot the puck.
No, 446 shots on the year. That's the most since Phil Esposito in 1971.
He would probably have that many that are blocked and that many that are shot wide. So this guy is closing in on about 1,400 shots on net. I'm glad I'm retired.
And Prosper along with Briere scores! Prosper with the shot through traffic, and UA never saw it. So Vinny Prosper, a late season acquisition from Tampa, 33 goals on the year and off the faceoff.
It is Hartnell. That is the man in front, 19, and this play was created because of an icing. Washington iced the puck, then they don't get their faceoff guy on the ice to take the draw. The Flyers get their matchup. They put the matchup out, and a faceoff play that creates the goal. This game is tied because of Vinny Prosper.
And it is Prosper's goal. Hartnell supplying the screen. And the Flyers answer 5 minutes and a second after the opening goal by Brashear.
And all of that because of a rule change. Typically with an icing, you can put anyone you want on the ice. They don't get their matchup, even though they're the home team.
Flyers goal.
Think about Prosper, 33 goals through the course of the season. He's an add-on at the trade deadline. You look at all the players that Paul Holmgren put in this lineup. You put Prosper there, he's an impact player right away. He leads your team in scoring.
Some chemistry immediately with Daniel Briere, who was brought in, intended to be the center for the injured Simon Gagné. So Matt Bradley back on the ice. Brashear and Côté go to the boards. Brashear went down. He's after the puck again, but out comes Philadelphia. And Kukkonen will loft it down into Washington ice. Milan Yurchina. And John Erskine. Only Tom Pody on the blue line for Washington has previous Stanley Cup playoff experience. Fired in by Steve Eminger, the former Kitchener Ranger. And there's Ryan Parrott, who gets the starting assignment tonight. Randy Jones has been under the weather with the flu, we're told, and he was a late scratch. Parrott in. Eminger off the glass. And now Baxton will get organized with Kozlov. Erskine plays it ahead. John Erskine was in the Dallas Stars organization when they were headed for a Stanley Cup, but did not play postseason action. He's looking forward to playing Philadelphia, his style of play. Now Richards trying to weave through center. Here's Richards over the line, and QA's got that. We passed the midway mark of the opening period, and we're tied at one. The first period is brought to you by Chevrolet. Hockey brings Canadians together. Chevrolet brings Canadians to hockey. Share your hockey stories at letsgochevrolet.ca.
Chris, when you're one of the best players in the game, it's amazing. Watch Ovechkin comes off the bench. As soon as he gets on the ice, he disappears with some sort of a cloaking device behind the Flyers' defense. I don't know how the great players in the game, the puck just seems to follow them around the moment their skates touch the ice. Now that last change, he came off the bench, was a questionable change, and he's been warned by the referee.
They're back on the ice to take that face off in the Washington zone. Hartnell and Crosby there against the Fedorov line, and turnover, and there's a shot by Briere with Crosby cruising through the crease again. Daniel Briere, Glenn, with 34 points in his last 34 postseason games.
Now, Cristobal Huey is the guy that I'm paying close attention to, Chris. Ninth best goals against in the NHL, but you look at the last 13 games that he played, he only gave up 11 goals, 5-on-5. And the last month was his best with a .75 goals against average. Led him to a 9-1 record. That's the reason the Washington Capitals are at the dance.
And there's Fleischman dancing in with the shot. That's blocked by Kuchin, and Gordon put it in front, cleared away. And Riley Cote sends it down the ice. Kept in by Carter. There's a hit on Upshaw from behind. Urchina's going off. Severing pass. Carter fighting for it. And Upshaw slow to get up. After the hit by Urchina, that will have the Capitals a man short.
Discipline. Urchina should know better. This particular play, Upshaw hits him here. Takes a good run out of both players. That's a solid hit. Nothing wrong with that. And then the play continues down the into the corner, and Drusina decides to exact some revenge. The only revenge that you can exact in playoffs is when you shake the other team's hand at the end and say, have a good summer.
Well, that's the element that Scotty Upshaw brings to the Flyers. Plays aggressive on the forecheck, and he disturbs things. And now Philadelphia, the difference during the regular season against Washington was a power play that went 5-for-22. Of course, the Flyers excelled on the power play throughout the season, ranked second to only the Montreal Canadiens. Richards battling there. Now held in by Timonen. That puck is up off the netting.
You're right, the power play was dominant. As you mentioned, second best in the National Hockey League, and that guy there led the team through the course of the season with 33 power play points. And he's back in the lineup now after missing two. Knee brace or not, you give this guy time and space. Not only does he have a good shot, but he's got the ability to feed people because he's got such great vision.
The official on the Flyer goal, by the way, cross goal from Timonen and Hartnell. And now Philadelphia going to work on the power play, trying to break this 1-1 tie. Tom Cody in the corner, Briere after it. There's Prosper up with it. Back to Richards, who mans the left point. That's knocked down. David Steckel in a penalty-killing role with Brooks Leich. Leich with three shorthanded goals on the season. And now Briere strikes back. Over the line, Briere. Great pass in, and a outstanding defensive play by David Steckel to break up the Prosper chance.
You got to see more urgency from the Washington Capitals. You can't have this slide. And I'll show you an example here. They get the puck, and they should have this puck, and it should be down the ice. Instead, two red sweaters get outmatched for the puck. And this last play is a 1-on-3. And because they don't go to Briere, because they don't show urgency, they almost get scored on. Vinny Crosby gets a real good chance. It's blocked.
Well, there's a weak link for Washington. 25th best penalty kill during the regular season. Matt Cook out there now. 45 seconds remaining. And the Flyers power play. Jeff Carter cruising in. And that one off the logo. of Cristobal Huey.
Can't have a letdown. You know, it's obviously the biggest game that you've ever played, and there are a number of Capitals that have never played a playoff game before. Get all kinds of energy from the crowd at the start. You couldn't wait 2 days to play the game. Okay, now you're into the game. Now you've got to find a way to continue with that pace. Drive the level of the game up. Have no setbacks. Teams that are experienced, they don't have the setbacks. The only one with a Stanley Cup ring on this roster is the guy who took the faceoff there, Chris, Sergei Fedorov, who's got three. The rest of them have never lifted the cup over their head.
Mike Knoebel on the ice. Three goals in his last two games against Washington, and a concern for the Caps on this power play. Knoebel battling for the puck now after it against Fedorov. Comes back to the point, held in by Coburn. Sent across by Carter. Here's Tiemannin. That's off a skate. Carter's got it. Back to big Braden Coburn. A shot. Huey doesn't know where it is. Heavy traffic in front of the net once again, but Washington gets it out. Under 7 minutes to go here in the opening period. Knoebel sends it in. That one took a funny hop with Huey out of the net. And now Washington back at full strength. Jim Dowd playing a postseason game with his seventh different team. Umberger overskates the puck. And Ovechkin will get it in. Kozlov on the forecheck. Picked up by Backstrom. Outstanding rookie, second among rookie scorers to Kozlov, who swiveled in front, nearly got loose. Now a shot from a point, deflecting in front. Off the stick of Erskine. Backstrom after Ovechkin, stepped into Umberger. Ovechkin good in that department, two a shot, he didn't miss by much. Alexander Ovechkin, ninth in the NHL this season in the hit department. Swung back by Backstrom as his line mates change. Daniel Briere has had a strong first period on a line with Hartnell and Prospel. Green lost an edge. Briere back to collect it. Braden Coburn off the board, past Hartnell, down the ice. Prospel on the forecheck, gets a piece of Sean Morrison just back in the Washington lineup. Off a shoulder injury down the stretch for the Caps. He's partnered with Mike Green and a real steadying influence for the offensively minded defenseman Green. Here's a puck played ahead, and Scotty Upshaw's okay, back after it, but Pody beats him to the puck, and he'll swing away. Here's Tom Pody to the attack, and it's offside as Pody whips the shot wide and will get some attention from the Flyer rear guard.
Any pass rush, don't miss the next pass rush game.
Some players, I think, Chris, just don't hit. And I think this guy is one. He likes to be hit. Dowd gives him a little shot that wakes him up. Then he says, okay, you can do that. I can do this better. And he takes a run at R.J. Umberger. Look what happens. In transition, gets a real good chance. Because this game is on the road for Philadelphia, I can't imagine that they want to play Kukkonen against Ovechkin. But that's the matchup that has happened so far tonight. Tiemannin has not been able to get on the ice enough with Alexander Ovechkin. And that's one of the reasons Ovechkin's had good chances. And he's found ways to break the defense of Philadelphia.
So, Glenn, you don't think the Philadelphia Flyers should give Ovechkin the Crosby treatment?
No. Mark Messier was that way as well. Anytime you played against him, there were games when he slept. And there were also games when you took a run at him and he woke the Giant up. And he exacted revenge on you in a big way. So I say no. I say you leave him alone. He loves to be hit. Loves to play Philadelphia. 12 games against Philadelphia. He's got 21 points. So obviously they haven't figured a way to master this guy yet, have they?
Goals in 11 of the 12 games as Jim Dowd worked his way in. Puck back out at center. Sent in by Modry. And John Erskine back to get it with 4 minutes remaining in the opening period. Sent in. Philadelphia won both regular season meetings here. The Flyers are a good road team all season long. 21 wins at home, 21 wins on the road. it off. Couldn't squeeze past two caps. Boyd Gordon back to his defense.
It is tough to look at that season series of these two clubs and really get much out of the numbers, though. You think back to November 23rd when these two clubs met. Washington had the worst record in the National Hockey League. February 6th when they played Chris in a 4-3 win for the Caps. The Caps led the division. A lot of that had to do with coaching changes and responsibility changes for key players.
To apologize for any technical or video problems that I understand we may have experienced. 1-1 the score. Jeff Carter, nice move. Carter busting in. Look for the short side and the puck ricochets out of play.
Can't look at the puck. It's a one-on-one. Pody's got to look at that big crest. Once you look down, you're done. One step to the outside and a real good scoring chance for the Philadelphia Flyers. Contain players. Keep Carter to the outside. You get to the outside, you get near the boards. The boards hurt.
Less than 3 minutes to go now. Ovechkin on the ice with Backstrom. And Kozlov. Carter squeezes Backstrom along the boards. There's a hit by Timonen, who's out there now matched up against Ovechkin. The matchup we understood that could likely happen. Ovechkin with a bouncing puck in front. And Mike Knubel with a fine defensive play. Ovechkin bumping with Carter. Around it goes. And the Flyers get it out to center. Alexander Ovechkin just out of the reach of Kozlov. And now John Erskine plays it off the boards into center ice, and Fedorov's got it. He'll wait till the shift change is complete. And now Steve Eminger won a Memorial Cup with one of his opponents tonight. Mike Richards on the other side. A little pass for Fedorov. Skipped over his stick. Otherwise, he was home free. Now Prospel nearly barging through. Prospel along the boards against Erskine. And we'd now like to welcome viewers as they battle along the boards. Prospel centers past Briere. And now I'd like to welcome the rest of the viewers to the main TSN network. 1-1 the score here late first period. Mike Green is centering pass. And that failed to click and back the other way. Hartnell across on the left side. Luke cruising down the left wing. Behind the net, Richards unable to come up with it. Flyers scored first on a goal by Donald Brashear. Or checked at the Capitals, a former Flyer. Donald Brashear with the goal. But Philadelphia answers just over 5 minutes later. Declav Prospel with the tying marker for Philadelphia. In the corner, Fedorov. Now Richards unable to come up with it. And Matt Cook gets it to center. Kukkonen out of the reach of Forrest, and dashing in, gets a good hit in on Green, a centering pass, and Fleischman's there. Couple dozen seconds remaining in the opening period. And a pass for Brooks Light just out of his reach. Timo Timonen starts back. He lost it. Here's Fleischman. 10 seconds left in the period. Sidestep the hit, but lost the puck. Off the glass to the line. Cody. And they're calling it offside with 4.2 seconds remaining in this first period. And there's Donald Brashear, the goal scorer.
Still a recap, Chris. For those that were watching golf, shame on you. Get to the alternate channel, watch this, and you'll see something you may never see again. Donald Brashear, no, not the dancing moves here. He scored a goal. Wow. And Vinny Prospel ties it up off of the faceoff. 1-1. 4 seconds left to go in the first period. Been a real spirited start. Ovechkin's been dominant, and this crowd has been electric.
Yes, expectations that this would be a terrific series, and the storyline through 20 minutes would indicate that. As you see the goal scorers heading off 1-1 after 20 minutes here in Washington, D.C., as we join James Duffy. Thank you, James. Interesting to hear Mark Rudecki's comments on Alexander Ovechkin. Hills, you're between the benches at ice level. Your thoughts on his first Stanley Cup playoff period?
He's 30 feet away, and he led the league in the regular season in goals, in points, in game-winning goals, power play goals, did it all through the regular season, and I like this first period. He is so close to breaking free and scoring. He had a couple good scoring chances in that period. Three of his shots were blocked. Only a matter of time before the blocks become shots and goals.
There's another hit, and he takes one in turn from Jason Smith. So Mark Recchi sees a little bit of Lindros and some of Mario Lemieux. Earlier this year, Lindy Ruff thought that the best comparison to a former star might be Mark Messier. So plenty of comparisons, and they're all at a pretty high level, aren't they?
No one comparing him to players like Brashear and Domi. That ilk. All the studs of the game, all the greats of the game, the guys who are in the record books and are in the Hall of Fame. First Russian player ever to lead the league in scoring.
Ovechkin feeds, Green a shot, and that's off the glove of Marty Baron. Kozlov gets it into the corner for Backstrom. And it's taken away by Patrick Thorsson. One hands it to Lupul, and now Thorsson in flight. Two-on-one possibility as he tries to get it across, but a good defensive stick breaks that play up. Thorsson to the bench.
Take that to the net. He's on his backhand, I know, but you've got a chance against Kozlov. Take to the net. Don't look for Briere. Defensive-minded player trying to think offensively.
Briere out there now with Prospel and Hartnell. They were a dangerous line for Philadelphia in the first period, and an icing call against Washington.
Here's a look at what some of the greats did in their first playoff game. Howe and Orr, no points. Lafleur, Gretzky's the best with a goal and an assist. And Ovechkin tonight, he's got the goose egg. He's got a couple hits. List of the great players of our game and what they did in their very first playoff game. So what can we expect from Ovechkin?
Well, some of the players younger than Ovechkin when they made their Stanley Cup playoff debut. Puck out of play. Gretzky, for example, was 19. Gordie Howe, also 19. Bobby Orr, 20. Mario Lemieux did not play a playoff game until he was 24. Again, Ovechkin with goals in 11 of 12 meetings against Philadelphia. From the faceoff, Washington prevailed. Glenn, it was interesting to note the faceoff stats in the first period. Capitals dominated the circle, winning 69%, and yet it was a faceoff loss that led to Philadelphia's goal. Yaroslav Modrý in his own zone. Up the boards, it got past Matt Cook. Now Erskine will fire it in. Around it goes, and Fedorov's got it. Tried to center it, and it was picked off by Briere. Now Scott Hartnell down the right side. Hartnell deep for Prospel. Prospel bodied by Green, who went down, and that shot from the side of the net. Jeff Carter off the bench. Carter had a good physical first period with three hits. Carter to the net, a backhand. Oh, just out of the reach of Knubel on the doorstep. A good play by Carter. Back on it, another centering pass of Jeff Carter, causing a commotion in the Washington zone. And Jeff Carter finished the year in terrific fashion. There were those trade rumors around the deadline, and right after he was not dealt, he got hot. Seven working in against Ryan Parent. Couldn't beat the young defenseman, and out goes to Upshaw. Scotty Upshaw winning a job back in the starting lineup in the final week of the regular season. Sammy Kapanen is out for Philadelphia tonight. And based on his reaction to practice this morning, Glenn, he's not happy he's not in the lineup.
We talked to John Stevens, the coach of Philadelphia. A helmet goes flying by at about 40 miles an hour. We look for the number. Yeah. Sammy's not happy.
No. Bluff down by Huey. And a face-off again in the Washington zone.
Let's take a look at what Ovechkin did in the first period. We talked about how close he is to breaking free. Wide open here, shot block. That's one of the three in the first period. Good, solid hit, then creates a scoring chance. This is a chance. Blocked again. So close to adjusting the trigger finger. All alone, 4 feet from the goaltender. Shot blocked there. Take away these shot blocks, and these are enormous scoring chances for the best scorer in the world.
David Steckel prevailing on that faceoff against Mike Richards. Steckel, seventh in the league in faceoffs on the year, picks off a pass there. He's just back after missing 13 with a broken finger. Shot from the point, off target. Emminger has lost his stick. And now Emminger unable to pick it up as Lupel took a shot. Off UA. Erskine up the boards, out of the reach of Brashear as the Flyers hem the Capitals in at the moment. Now up on the right side for Matt Bradley, who drew an assist on the goal by Brashear in the opening period. Here's a nice pass. Steckel, a shot, scores! David Steckel has his first Stanley Cup playoff goal.
Chip and chase, Chris. Chip and chase. Use your size. You can't put the loose noose on somebody. There's the chip, now the chase. Use your size. This line is a cycle line that can create good chances because of their strength and their size. Bradley makes a real nifty pass. Backhand blind between the legs. Perfectly placed shot.
Glenn, that's a pair of goals for Washington's fourth line, as David Steckel gives the Caps their second lead of the night. So on a night where all eyes are on number 8, Alexander the Great, a fourth line trio takes Washington to the lead again.
Well, you know, everybody contributed in this line. I mean, Brashear in the defensive zone. Fence had lost their stick. Brashear ended up shooting the stick to the defenseman. That's how the puck ended up getting out of the zone. So Brashear doesn't get on the score sheet, but he helped in the defensive zone, which then ended up helping in the offensive zone. So it all contributed.
Matt Bradley has a pair of assists in the game. John Erskine on the score sheet as well, an assist on Steckel's goal.
Here's the play by Brashear. No stick. Let me help you out here. Now, granted, it wasn't exactly the best stick toss for Emminger. Nonetheless, did the job. Emminger chipped the puck out, and Steckel ends up chipping it in.
Everybody talks about how physical, how tough Philadelphia is, but that is a line with plenty of sandpaper for Washington. Upshaw spins, and that shot looked like it hit Ovechkin's stick, lying prone on the ice. Ovechkin will go back to get it now as the puck is rimmed by the Flyers. Yurchina along the boards. Puck comes loose. Upshaw gets it deep. Carter on it. Up against Pody. Now Upshaw, jolted by Yurchina. They're back at one another as they were in the first period. Carter will cycle it back. Mike Knubel. Tracked by Pody. Timo Timonen at the point for Upshaw, and Yurchina gets another jolt in on the Fort McMurray native. Timo Timonen getting things organized behind Philadelphia's net. Pass ahead, chopped into the zone by Hartnell. And Mike Green sporting his playoff mohawk. Knocked off the puck. Washington gets it back. And a good aggressive play by Matt Cook. On the left side, his wrong wing is 7. Dropped for Fedorov. Cook to the net. That shot steered away by Biron. Off the skate. It ricochets to the line. Morrison shoots it wide of the net. Boston unable to come up with it. And Washington's got it. Fedorov across. Erskine shot in front. Cook on the doorstep. Knocked down in front. Mike Green holds the zone. That one comes up and hits Scott Hartnell. Now it's Crosby to the line, but still in Philadelphia ice. Pressure here by Washington. Cook can't find it. And the Flyers send it the length of the ice. Emminger will go back to get the icing call. Fans like what they see as Washington has regained the lead here at the Verizon Center. Closed captioning of the NHL on TSN brought to you by the 2008 Kia Rondo, Canada's urban utility vehicle. From Kia, the power to surprise.
Chris, I like the game from the fourth line, but I also like the game of Cook and Fedorov. Here's Fedorov at the point. Why is he there? Because he's on the ice a lot with Mike Green. And Mike Green, he's a rover. This guy loves to gamble and take chances offensively. And you've got to have that defensive responsibility. Fedorov has been great all night long.
Here's Troy Gordon, a turnover and a shot knocked down in front. That one blocked by the youngster parent. Brooks Light into the corner. Troy Gordon is there. He's watched by Kukkonen. In support is Light. To the point, Sean Morrison, a shot, and Biron's got that. And again, the traffic heavy is Boyd Gordon with a spill through the goal crease.
Well, Chris, Bruce Boudreau, when they came up with a slogan, rock the red, he wears a red shirt. The owner of the Leonsis says, well, that's great, you're into it. That's great. You got the red shirt on. Bruce says, what are you talking about? I have no idea.
He said,
well, red shirt night, right?
He said, I just happened to put a red shirt on with my suit. Leonsis said, who wears a red shirt with a suit? This guy's right out of central casting.
Oh, yes.
Oh, he's been a terrific story here. A beloved coach of the Capitals. His first win as an NHL coach, Glenn, was against these Flyers back on November 23rd. An overtime victory provided off the stick of Nicholas Backstrom. A reminder that the NHL on TSN Stanley Cup playoffs continue with game two of our doubleheader. Colorado facing off against Minnesota. Live coverage begins immediately following this game. Also available on TSN.ca. Speaking of overtime, Joe Sakic does it again, providing the Avalanche.
Well, speaking of this game and Bruce Boudreau, 37 wins since he's taken over. And Leonsis should be happy about that red shirt because they've sold 2,000 season tickets since this club made their push to the playoffs. That's called ka-ching, ka-ching.
And Glenn, when we were here in, what, late October, early November, it was count the crowd during the national anthem, and it didn't take long.
Crickets in the building.
Now the Flyers going to work. Puck will be held in by big Braden Coburn. David Steckel up with it, along with Brashear, the line that's done the damage so far tonight. Matt Bradley, along with Steckel and Brashear. Donald Brashear's third Stanley Cup playoff goal. The first two were with the Flyers, and now he's jostling with R.J. Umberger on the change. And Umberger goes to the bench after exchanging a couple of pushes with big Donald Brashear. Here comes Kimmo Timonen to the attack over the line. Thorsson drives to the net, picked away by Huey, centered by Richards. That's picked off, and Kozlov tried to send away Ovechkin, but out of his reach. Now Jason Smith on the ice against the Ovechkin line. The captain of a pass that sailed past Thorsson. Icing wave. Richards with a flyby on Huey. And Kozlov in his own zone. Kozlov heated up on this line in the second half of the year. Four goals in the first 40 games. He finishes with 16, and now he's got it. Here's Kozlov trying to barge through with a poke check by Biron. Kozlov centers all the way back to the point. Green jolted by Upshaw and lost possession. And away goes Jeff Carter. Here's Carter for Upshaw. Long range, Huey had trouble with it. And sits down on the puck. Upshaw causing a disturbance at the side of the net. And Ian Green with a little extracurricular. Guy who likes that as our Stanley Cup update. Darren Detition.
What song do you want to hear next? Text 1DC for Dance Commander by Electric Six. 2DC for Cables to Arms by Drunkkick Murphys, or 3DC for Men in the Box by Alex and James. Text in right now to 323-91. Let your voice be heard.
scramble play by Huey. This puck dips on him, and he's typically the butterfly guy who goes down 90% of the time. He stays up on that one. A dip puck almost finds its way through the wickets.
You think he's looked a little uneasy tonight? There's a blocker stop by Huey.
Well, there is this natural, I guess, letdown after you make the playoffs. I mean, they won the last seven games in a row to make the playoffs, and all of them against teams in their division.
This is centering pass, but a penalty upcoming. It's a slashing call, and Daniel Briere's going off of Scott Hartnell. Crosspull. Mike Green all involved in the goal crease. I think some of the players heard the whistle.
All the Flyers can become engaged here because the whistle and is because of a penalty, and the faceoff will come outside anyway. So Philadelphia don't have to worry about losing faceoff position based on their defense jumping in the play.
Matt Cook in the midst of it.
There's the penalty, Chris. Two-handed slash.
Slash on the hands of Sean Morrison.
And in they come. Green's a rookie to this and is the best scoring defenseman goal-wise in the National Hockey League. So you got to send a little message when you get a chance. Green would like to send a message the other way as he sends his team on the power play.
You know, Glenn, I think there's this perception that the Flyers are that much bigger and badder, but I'm not so sure Washington can't handle the Flyers in the physical department.
Well, there is this aura, and it's been there since the 70s when the Flyers were the big, bad Broad Street bullies. But you look at guys like Crosspull and Dowd, Kukkonen. You think that's a tough team? A team that should be feared? I'm not buying it. I don't think Washington's buying it either. They're tough guys, Cote, and to me, he's not a heavyweight. He's a middleweight or a middle heavyweight. Here's Brashear. Too many men on the ice here. They've already made their change in Washington. Shane Heyer throws him off the ice, or it's too many men on the ice. Here, Brashear, absolutely furious to get pushed off the ice.
That fourth line for Washington, two guys 6'3", the other 6'5", all over 230 pounds. And they provided both goals for the Caps, who now go to the power play, trying to extend this lead in the second period. Seven exchanging passes and now plays back for Ovechkin. The lone man at the point, Seven holds. Circles back, fires, and a glove stop by Marty Baron. Fedorov knocked down in front, and that draws a reaction.
Capitals are desperate to get the shot set up by Ovechkin, and what they do is they take Green, who is a defenseman, and they throw him down the side of the net. That tries to get, there's Green, top of your screen, he's a defenseman. No, not really, he's a rover, he's a forward. All he wants to do is bring that box down, bring the Philadelphia Flyers down to the front of the net so they can set up the shot from OV.
Fedorov wins the faceoff, Green moves down once again, and now cheats back to the right point. Ovechkin, Seven, shot doesn't get through. Alexander Ovechkin led the league in power play goals with 22.
Hey. Green's in the slot. If he wants to do some color, he can come over and stand between the benches too. Why not?
That puck is out of play. Capitals want a penalty, but it did deflect and apparently hit a Capital because it's coming outside the line.
Let's take a look at the rover. There's Green defenseman. I'll settle myself here in the slot. I'll drift back out. All of this to get the box to sink down so that they can set up the shot for number eight. This guy's just a dynamic player offensively. What a wonderful season. First time since 88-89, the leading goal scorer in the National Hockey League is a forward, Ovechkin, and the leading goal scorer for defensemen on the same team. Lemieux and Coffey were the last two to do it.
Chance right in front there, and the puck shot wide by Ovechkin. It'll be Kozlov. Under a half minute remaining in the power play. Tom Pody now at the point. Brooks Light on the second power play unit. Alexander Ovechkin on both power play units. Here's a chance. Lightman in front. Off Perron and pass Light. Flyers clear. And Philadelphia gets a last penalty kill change as Pody. Last call for this power play. 5 seconds left as he drifts it in. Huron out, got crossed up with Coburn. They lose it. Kozlov centers. And now the Flyers back at full strength. Briere takes the pass. Daniel Briere scores out of the penalty box and has the tying goal.
The tired group in Washington, they're out for the power play. They don't get a change, and they're not aware of the time on the clock when Briere steps on the ice. Emminger should be a step back. Briere does a great job to stay onside, and with that wedge of a stick that he has, he just puts this in a perfect spot, and it's upstairs. Most cases for Briere, he's got to shoot upstairs. Almost got like a sand wedge for a curve on his stick. So bad on the Washington Capitals for not being aware of the amount of time left on the penalty kill.
When you were talking in our last regular season broadcast in Philadelphia about when you have an option of getting a player to serve a penalty, putting in an offensive talent, there's another example, a guy out of the box, right to the attack. Nobody better offensively for Philadelphia than Daniel Briere. 38 Stanley Cup playoff points, that's tops on the Flyers. And he now has points in 15 of his last 16 possible scores, and Philadelphia has the lead. The goals come 33 seconds apart.
Lousy execution by the Washington Capitals. They've got a set to break out. Now there is no pressure here at all, none. Instead, they make a whole play to three players that have blown the zone. Now they're faced with the turnover game and a 3-on-2. Now, I'm no rocket scientist, but if there's three guys, I don't want the guy who's 7 feet away from the goalie in the slot shooting this shot. Could you give it to somebody on the side? Maybe we could have something of a shot from an angle. That's the most dangerous player on the ice. And they give him that chance off of a set breakout. Inexcusable.
Now things have changed, Glenn. It was a 2-1 Capital lead. Washington on the power play. Flyers get the penalty kill. Get a goal from the man out of the box. And then get another one 33 seconds later. Talked about Washington getting two from their fourth line. The top line for the Flyers has all three. Two by Prospel. The other by Briere. Now it's Fedorov back with a shot into the glove of Marty Baron. So Prospel from Tiemannin and Hartnell after Briere had scored. 3-2 Flyers.
Goal scorers, Chris, 33 seconds apart, and Washington, they have themselves to blame for this. Surely this cannot be their set breakout. Everybody leave the zone and then have your defenses try to rifle it up to the golden mitts of Mr. Brashear, and then you give away this on the rush. Pretty simple. Come up the ice with some sort of a structure.
Talk to the first period about some chemistry that has evolved between those two. Seven off the draw. A glove stop by Marty Baron. Another face-off win for Sergei Fedorov.
It's been a strong point for the Washington Capitals, and they like to set up face-off plays with Ovechkin. Well, this guy, Semin, he's got an absolute bomb for a shot as well. A wicked curve on his stick. I'd say borderline illegal.
Oh, the stick police are out again.
Yes. Well, it's playoff time. Not one stick measurement through the course of the year. Not one. I find that hard to believe that everybody in the National Hockey League is following the rules. I know I didn't. My pads were legal for about a week.
Do tell.
My first year.
Here's Mike Richards, a pass, and that's cut off by Matt Cook. And the Sterling, Ontario product goes to work, flipping it in. Fedorov gives chase. Cook with a hit on Coburn away from the puck, and that's going to be an interference penalty. Flyers go to work. Here's a chance in front of the big stop by Huey off Joffrey Lucwell, who was in alone. But there will be a power play for Philadelphia. Nevertheless, a huge Huey stop on another golden opportunity. Well, tonight's TSN Netcam brought to you by Sharp Aquas. There's more to see.
You got to touch the puck before you're able to blast through with a hit. No one touches the puck here. Cook comes in. Fedorov actually has the puck. Now with that little extra energy and with that aggressive style of forecheck by Washington, they also then forgot to play defense. Lupo had a great chance, and UA may have saved, remember that save, because he may have saved the bacon for Washington Capitals.
At the second best power play in the NHL goes to work. A shot, UA the stop. Rebound is cleared. Boyd Gordon sends it down ice. Second power play of the night for Philadelphia. 0-1 with one shot on their opening advantage. Broken up just inside the line. Good stick by Sean Morrison, the former first-round draft choice of the Boston Bruins. Jeff Carter goes to work. Tom Podium to duck by the Carter shoot-in. Erskine with a hit in the corner. Flyers had it, but lost it. And Brooks likes away. Like working against Coburn. Coburn down. And from the seat of his pants, played it ahead. Philadelphia will try and get this organized. Yaroslav Modrý back, 1 minute done in the Cook interference penalty. Now Mike Richards can't thread it through. The play offside at the Washington line.
Philadelphia Flyers are trying to carry the puck into the zone. They can't do that. They're all lined up with Washington. So what do you got to do to get the puck in and get set up? Plays like that. A good dump, and this puck hits the glass and it just dies on the boards. That's when you can create your pressure. And they end up keeping the puck in for their only sustained period of this power play, which is about 20 seconds. A one shot on net, but that's it. Carrying the puck into the zone for Philadelphia with a lineup of four red sweaters, it's impossible.
Here's David Steckel on the forecheck, coming up with the puck. And Hartnell gets it back. Outlets for Kimmo Tiimonen. And not much doing yet on the Flyer power play. Now they're in with a half minute left. Mike Richards walks in front, scores! Daniel Briere on the pass from Richards. And it's 4-2 Philadelphia.
Washington Capitals are hot. They think that this puck was played by Biron 200 feet away in the no-play zone. Trapezoidal area, whatever the experts call it. And so they're hot. They think this should have been a penalty. And it's not called. Take a look to see if they have a beef. And then the play gets set up through mid-ice. Through mid-ice. And by simply carrying the puck over the zone, again, the top line for Philadelphia Flyers doing the job.
Well, the big question would be whether or not Briere would be able to get back in the lineup for this after the screen being late in the season. He's come back with a vengeance. A pair of goals for him. Line made cross for the other two. A power play marker for the Flyers. And they have scored three in a row to lead 4-2. So Daniel Briere is hot. Vinny Prospel, an assist on the power play goal. Minutes 36 seconds for Philadelphia. Briere from Knubel, Prospel from Tiimonen and Kukkonen, Briere from Prospel and Richards on the power play. 4-2 Philly. They're making the noise, and it's been a quiet second period for number 8, Glenn. There's Kozlov in and a shot wide. Back to the point with Chyna. That one blocked by Richards, who went down. Where is it? Richards looking for it, finds it, and clears it. And icing the call against Philadelphia.
Now let's take a look at this play to see if Washington has a beef. They believe that Biron played this in the trapezoidal area. And the pictures are pretty clear there that he didn't. Everything was okay with that play because the puck then went from there to the back of the net for Washington. I think Washington, they've got to start getting the puck deep and start using that aggressive forecheck that's led them to success against Philadelphia.
Morrison, a shot to the side of the net. Kozlov with the redirect. Direct and now out in front, a shot. And Marty Baron's got that as Kozlov looks dangerous. And now Backstrom in the middle of, with Tiemannin.
Well, there's no sense getting involved in these scrums. This is good for Philadelphia. This is just wasted energy for Washington. Good tip by Kozlov. Baron knows he's got to tip it back into his body, so he takes that away. The defense for Washington in this scrum, they can't come in. So it's 5-3. You know, Philadelphia can do whatever they want. And all you're doing is exerting energy for the Ovechkins, the Kozlovs, and the Backstroms. I think it's a good play by Philadelphia. I think it's a bad play to get engaged for Washington.
Face off one. Morrison steps up. There's Morrison's shot, and Baron's got that. And they'll face off again in the Flyers' zone.
Face-offs are a big strong point for the Washington Capitals, Chris, particularly for Fedorov, who's north of 50%. He's had his way, and they create chances off of face-offs. All you do, play in your own end when you lose face-offs time after time. Force your goaltenders to make saves, force your players to block shots. You know, it's fun to play with the puck. It's hard work to play defense.
Back-to-back face-off wins for David Steckel, who has Washington's goal in this period. Matt Bradley with a hit on Parent. Ryan Parent with it. Bradley goes after him again. This fourth line for Washington has provided the offense and now trying to provide a jolt of energy. Steve Eminger back. Again, Eminger into the lineup with the injury to Jeff Schultz. Schultz hoping to be back for game two. Muldrick can't clear. Bradley knocked it down. Upshaw across. And here comes Carter and Knubel over the line. Jeff Carter swings wide. Unable to center. And Brashear back defensively. 2.5 left. Here in the second period, it's been a big one for the Flyers. Muldry will drift it back in. Fedorov will collect it for Washington, and that was a dangerous pass that does find Matt Cook, who goes to work. Cook with a chip and chase. Warded off by Muldry. Fedorov after it now, and Cook comes away with it. Up the boards and out. And Crosby will spin it to the Washington line. Briere back on the ice, back to work, and a blocker stopped by Huey. And this puck over the glass, Flyers think it should be a penalty. And let's see. Yes, yeah. Mike Green is going off for delay of game. And it goes from bad to a little worse here in the second for Washington.
It's a tough play here for Green. He's got to make this play in tight quarters, under pressure. All he's trying to do is get the puck out of the zone, relieve some of the pressure that he feels from the forecheck. Right near river. That's two or less.
Tom Pody sends it back. Third Philadelphia power play. 1-for-2. And this line has been too much so far for Washington. Briere, Crosby, and Hartnell. Hartnell in after first. Crosby in support. Tiemannin and Richards are the point men. And here's the shot by Crosby. It ricochets Richards. Briere centers through the blue ice. Hartnell camped in front. Back up to Richards. Knocked off the stick of Briere by Pody. Caps up with it and clear. 1 minute remaining.
1 minute
in the second period. 70 seconds left in the Mike Green minor. Timo Tiemannin drips it in. Out of the reach of UA. Off the skate to Cook. Erskine to the line. And that did come out. And it's called on the offside. Well, the NHL Stanley Cup playoffs continue on TSN Saturday as the Predators take on the Detroit Red Wings. Live coverage begins at 1:30 Eastern, 10:30 a.m. Pacific, and it's available on TSN HD. Didn't see Glenn Healy get his Mike Green-inspired mohawk.
Yeah, I didn't see you doing that either.
I think, did Boudreaux get one or no? He's got the reverse mohawk, doesn't he?
I'm a little closer to the... But here is a large contingent that did get the Mike Green mohawk for the postseason.
New wave. Remember my first year in the playoffs, Ken Baumgartner ended up dyeing his hair and he shaved his head and put his number in his head. That was my roommate, and I thought, boy, am I in for a tough National Hockey League career if I'm living with clowns like this. Now he's got his degree and his master's, and he's really cleaned himself up nice and growed up.
Now winding character. Down, less than a half minute remaining in the second period. Now a power play, broken up, steckalized the clock, and dumps it down. Dozen seconds left in the period. One last dash, led by Coburn. Carter, wrist shot wide. Looks like turns with it. Gordon over the line, and time has expired. Coburn with a late hit, and that gets a response. And we will see how Washington responds in the third. Capitals took the lead on a goal by Steckel, then 3:36. And it's the Flyers 4-2 after 2 as we join James Duffy. Thank you, James. And Glenn, the Philadelphia Flyers doing a nice job of preempting the Alex Ovechkin show.
Yeah, Washington, their inexperience to me, really starting to shine. 15 players having their first tonight for Washington. Talk about first. How about the first time that this guy has allowed 3 goals as a member of the Washington Capitals? And this should be a first as well. 0 points, 0 shots, and 2 scoring chances.
Well, we all thought he had a good first period, but very quiet in the second. But he has made a lot of noise in the third period this year. 29 third period or overtime goals out of the 65 for Ovechkin. And they need him to step up now as the Flyers have a 2-goal lead. And here goes Ovechkin to work. Over the line, Nicklas Backstrom, and that's shot blocked. Down went Richards to block that chance. Swung in front off a skate. And Joffrey Lupo will turn back. Lupo drops the shot, and that changed direction. Ends up wide of the net. And now Mike Green taking off. Here's Green over the line. Mike Green, left shot, testing Marty Baron. And the Flyers roll it the length of the ice. Morrison back to touch it. And that's icing. 1 minute and 1 second into the third.
Nothing for Ovechkin. 3 points tonight for Briere. You can't tell me that some of the history between these two guys, when Briere was with the Buffalo Sabres and then he decided to introduce himself, Mr. Ovechkin's package. You can't tell me that there isn't something extra in this game. And Briere has brought it tonight. 2 goals, an assist, and the star players, Chris, have been just that, the star players for Philadelphia.
You know, we saw it. Game 1, Rangers-Devils. Drury and Gomez, the highly touted free agent acquisitions, paying early playoff dividends, especially Scott Gomez with 3 assists. And Daniel Briere has done likewise tonight after his huge offseason signing with Philadelphia, 8 years and $52 million. Briere playing on a gimpy knee, ordering a brace, but he has been a huge force. Now Semin trying to get something going for Washington. Puts it in front of the net. Here's a chance, score! What a pretty goal! And it's Mike Green off the point! That's a 1-goal game!
Philadelphia Flyers are puck watching. And because they're all watching the puck, hey, everyone in the building knows who's got it. Simmons got it. Look at all five of them staring at the puck. What's going on behind them? That. Greens are over. He'll jump in the rush, jump backdoor any chance he can. Absolute perfect shot. Most guys would drive this into the goaltender's pillows. Not Green.
And a Bobby Orr finish for his first Stanley Cup playoff goal. How about the eyes in the back of his head pass by Sergei Fedorov for his 164th Stanley Cup playoff point. Here come the Caps again. With the assist, Fedorov now leads all active Stanley Cup playoff participants in assists with 114. One ahead of Chris Chelios. Alexander Semin, the other assist on the Green goal.
That's the magic. We showed earlier in the period where Fedorov backed up Green. Because Green's a guy who's going to take chances, and Fedorov's a guy you can trust on the ice with him. Fedorov played defense when he was in Detroit at times. Scotty Bowman's crazy idea that just seemed to work. And when you're on the ice and you have that chemistry with players and you know Green's going to take chances, you look for him. Philadelphia Flyers didn't, and that's why it's a one-goal game.
Mike Green didn't lead the league in goals by defensemen, but did not score in the last 17 regular season games. Now Umberger unable to reach it, and Green's got it. Riley Cote on the ice for Philadelphia. With Dowd and Umberger, the fourth line for the Flyers. Puck is sent in, and Brooks Like is going to get there first. Taking the board, who wins the battle? Brooks Like and Bradley in deep. And now back the other way goes Umberger. Rolls it in and gets a change. Up ahead for Fleischman out of his reach and teaming him. Back in his own zone. The place is charged now after the Green goal at 1:50 of the third. Scott Hartnell shooting it in on UA, and he'll elect to hold it with Prospel bearing down. We'll close captioning of the NHL on TSN, brought to you by the 2008 Kia Rondo, Canada's urban utility vehicle from Kia, the power to surprise.
Puck frozen by Huey there. I'd like to see him play it. Philadelphia Flyers were in the midst of the change. He looks at his face-off prowess of his team at 60% and trusts the fact that they'll win the draw. Which they did.
There goes Ovechkin. Looking cross ice at Kozlov cruising, and Richards knocks down the return pass up off Lukul. Erskine will turn it back. Nicholas Backstrom sends it across. Good move by Kozlov. Now Ovechkin's side of the net. Richards tracking him. We've had just about everything but Alexander Ovechkin. And that might be on its way here. Here's Kozlov again. He's looked dangerous so far tonight. Puts it into the slot. Knocked away by Timonen. Ovechkin able to hook up with Kozlov, but a good jolt there by Kozlov on Richards. Backstrom let it go. Kozlov centers. Ovechkin was being watched by Lukul, and now Lukul breaks away. Joffrey Lukul is in, and he was checked, and it got by Ovechkin, who heads off on a change. Just past the four-minute mark of his third period. Here's Upshaw across, and that chance is negated on a sliding block by Emminger. And Cook off the boards and out. Semin to work. Over the line, tripped up. Fans react, but the officials don't. Fedorov, one hands it to Semin in front, and a great shot there. Rebound, backhanded wide by Cook. What a great play by Semin. And that wraparound style shot, but Carver's away. Barging in, shot, Huey's got that. And a big stop to keep it a one-goal game as Carter gets another chance.
Starting to heat up here in Washington. Watch the good defensive play by Richards. He might as well be inside the pants of Ovechkin, as he does a great job of making sure Ovechkin doesn't get free. Then he ends up blocking his shot here. These two have actually fought at times. And then good play by Semin on the wraparound here. No stick for Smith. And so he takes it right to the jar. That last two-on-one, Washington gave up. Green gave Carter far too much time and too much space. I know as a defenseman you're supposed to take the pass, but certainly don't give a guy a breakaway. Big save by Huey at the right time.
Faceoff win by Briere. Prospel sends it across. Ryan Parrott will get it deep. Huey was knocked down in the crease. He's still down. Snow Angel. Play stopped. And the Capitals wondering why Huey was dumped and no call.
There has been lots of traffic on Huey. Hartnell's been a royal pain in the butt. And Briere here in this particular play, I mean, he gets knocked down, he knocks the goaltender down. In the rule book, you're not allowed, you have to let the goaltender play the game. No matter whether he's in the blue paint, outside the blue paint, he's in the corner. So I'd like to have seen an earlier whistle here. The referee's over explaining. Fine, you don't want to call a penalty, but blow it down. Because if somebody banks that puck off you, eh? Then what are you going to hear?
Briere down. Up center out for Bradley, who has a pair of assists in the game. Here comes Joy Gordon over the line. Brooks Light with a shot, misses short side. Odium deep. Active defense for the Washington Capitals. It's helped them get back in it on the play by Green early in the period. Urchina fires it in. And now we do have a penalty. A high sticking call upcoming against the Flyers.
The guy with 3 points tonight, so this one, you're on that Flyer bench, let's kill it for this guy. He's been a hero tonight. Here's a look at the penalty. Gets the puck out of the zone on his back end, and here's footsteps. Why wouldn't he? Bradley's hit pretty much everything all night long.
10th best power play during the regular season against the 10th best penalty kill unit. Backs were knocked down, and the Flyers cleared. Patrick Morrison out in a penalty-killing capacity for Philadelphia. Ovechkin with the touch pass for Fedorov. He'll rim it around. Seven on the far side, trying to return it. Smith unable to clear. Ovechkin at the left point for Fedorov. Trading passes with Ovechkin. A seven for Fedorov. Alexander seven, Fedorov to the front. Cross ice for Paxton. He's set it up on the other side now. And that gives Ovechkin a chance to cheat down in front.
Get him the puck and he's going to score. You know it. Hit it 65 times during the year.
Mike Green is shot. That's blocked by Thorsson and he's in trouble. Thorsson can't get up. A chance for Green. Fires. Scores!
They better be doing leg surgery on Thorsson. He goes down for the block, and I know these things hurt. But the referee is not going to blow this whistle unless he thinks the player is in some sort of peril. I don't think that's peril. That's pain, but not peril. And then the play continues on. Now it's a 4-on-3. What a rocket. And the celebration by the Washington Capitals tells it all. This hockey club, just what they think about this time of year. They all jumped on each other and laid in a big heap at center ice for about 15 seconds. Now Richards is going to make a point to the referees that the play should have been called and whistled down, but
a long discussion with Brad Watson. Thorsson clearly in difficulty, but it doesn't matter. This game is tied at 4. And no team in the league celebrates better than the Capitals as Ovechkin celebrates his first Stanley Cup playoff point. And Thorsson in a completely different frame of mind.
Now, I was part of the game where Alexei Kovalev went down. against the Quebec Nordiques. And Andy Van Halen unsure about blowing the whistle because he wasn't sure of how hurt Kovalev was. And Joe Sakic scored a goal on me that would have made it 3-0. He called the goal back because of Kovalev's injury. It stayed at 2-0. We won in overtime. And Quebec eventually got eliminated. And Andy Van Halen eventually lost his job a year later. That's a tough call for a referee to recognize the significance of the injury on a player and decide whether he should take away a power play opportunity.
Green from Ovechkin and Backstrom, furious action. Ryan Parent keeps it in at the left point. There's David Steckel with it. So a power play goal for the Caps, each team with a power play marker. Dead even at 4 in a wild one. Here in Washington, Mike Knubel, long-range shot. Off the blocker of Cristobal Huey. These two teams, the exact same defensive record during the year. Here's a giveaway and a shot. Stopped by Huey.
That save there, Chris. That was deflected. Kozlov got a stick on it. Redirected.
Hartnell gets it behind the net. Briere to Prosper. That's broken up. Chopped off the stick of Erskine. Briere back on it. This line has given the fits all night. Hartnell with a stop there by Huey off Hartnell on the doorstep. And here goes Ovechkin. Sending it across, and that's broken up by Coburn. It is electric here at the Verizon Center. And getting louder by the minute. Mike Green back. Teams changing. Ovechkin just scrambling off. And an icing call against the Caps. 8.5 minutes into the third. Locked at 4.
The goals tonight for Mike Green. He has brought this building to its feet. Not often you get 2 goals by a defenseman. That's 19 for the season. He had 18 in the regular season. And not before too long, here comes number 20. 18 in the regular season, 2 tonight. And he's brought the Washington Capitals back into this game. Cinderella story. Well, don't break the glass slipper yet. We're still alive.
Keep this up. There'll be a whole lot more Mohawks in the U.S. Capitol. 2 goals in 4:26 here in the third after the Flyers had taken charge with 3 in 3:36. In the second, Jason Smith back in his own zone. Fedorov line out for the Caps. Joffrey Lupul, Mike Richards, and RJ Umberger stepping up on this line and now heading off to the bench. Seventh slides it through for Cook, the former Canuck. Now back to Simmons. Bumped by Coburn a couple of times as he works the wall. Caps come off the boards with it. Now Coburn will take over. Braden Coburn in his first Stanley Cup playoff action. Now Upshaw, a good hit there, delivered by Ersey. Knubel, bodied by Eminger. And looks like plays it to the far corner. Matt Bradley will turn it up ice. Matt Bradley in his first playoff action in 6 years. Last time he was in, he was a member of the San Jose Sharks. Thomas Fleischman, a return pass. He was Bruce Boudreau's big scorer when they won the Calder Cup 2 years ago. Tom Cody in his own zone, flips ahead, bled down by Parent, but Brookslide has it. Just out of the reach of Fleischman. Past the midway mark of the third period. Ryan Parent up off the boards, out of the reach of Prosper. And Cody with Hartnell in pursuit. Hartnell bumping into Huey. Up the length of the ice, icing Washington, and we will step out in this 4-4 tie.
All right, sorry, Chris. Just say OV, quiet night for Ovechkin. 14 shifts, 5 hits, 3 chances, no shots.
First Stanley Cup playoff point, primary assist on the Green equalizer.
That's, I guess, the good news for Philadelphia. The bad news for Washington, he hasn't scored. But I say that's the bad news for Philadelphia because he hasn't scored. And it's only a matter of time.
Oh, well, somebody scored. Let's go back to Dutch. Softy after the goal that Brodeur allowed the game winner the other night that he took the blame for. Mention Ovechkin, by the way, Glenn. 19 of his 65 goals scored in the final 10 minutes of games this year. We have 9 minutes left in a 4-4 tie.
Well, that's the thing. You can check these kinds of players for only so long. Stuck.
Nice move by Rick or by Green to start the play, and now he'll take a return pass. Green in, and a hot shot taken off the shoulder, and look who is on the doorstep. But a big stop by Biron, and we step out for another Stanley Cup update. And here, Mike Green is stealing some thunder from the great eight. Boy, he's been terrific in this third period, hasn't he, Glenn?
Oh, he's been fantastic. The most dominant player for both teams.
But the dominant line is on the ice for Philadelphia. Briere, Prospel, and Hartnell. Here's Prospel. Another chance, and unable to get the shot away as Urchina takes him to the corner. Center, Briere shot. Blocked by Cody. Briere's got it again at the point. And Seven there to knock it away. And go to work. It's a 3-on-2. Alexander Seven with Fedorov. A shot. Rebound. And it's cleared away by Beaudry. Held in at the line. And now Prosper will take over. If you're wondering, neither Briere or Prosper has ever registered a Stanley Cup hat trick. Both sitting on a pair tonight. As is Mike Green. 7:47 left. Third period. Upshaw into the air. Carter comes down with it. Weak shot wide. Upshaw in pursuit. Can't come up with it. Here's Matt Cook. Playing it deep. Brooks like on it. Ryan Parrott checks him. Got a follow-up, however. Gordon came up with it. Like will turn and a shot. Glancing off a leg wide. Carter heads up ice. Bouncing it in. As Philadelphia makes changes, and Ovechkin loose. Ovechkin, quick shot. Biron the same. He got brushed by his teammate. And Ovechkin's got it again. There was that play where Ovechkin likes to sneak in behind and take the pass. Now Kozlov trying to work his way in front. Point shot, Green, well wide. Backstrom. Ovechkin in the corner. Teaming it all over him. And a chance to clear. Flyers get it out off the stick of Knubel. Ovechkin heads to the bench. And Teaminen awaits with Coburn as Philadelphia completes a change too. Jason Smith. Now it's up ahead for Lukel. Joffrey Lukel cross ice to the captain. Smith gets it in, and Richards goes after it. Mike Richards tries to center, crashing in is Umberger, who's been elevated from fourth line duty. Smith right point, fanned on it. Fedorov's away, 2-on-1. Fedorov across, and a return pass doesn't get there. Seven holds, shoots, and he fires it high, and it's up on the screen as they botch a chance with a 2-on-1. Fedorov and Seven with a chance, 5:49 to play. Well, they're loving the return to the Stanley Cup playoffs here in Washington. Tonight's game story brought to you by Molson Canadian, the true taste of the game.
Now, there's the game story there. Here's my game story. Think Ovechkin's worth $10 million? Every one of these people dressed the same, on their feet, to see one guy who's carried this team all through the year.
Well, red, the primary color here, but in the third period, it's been green. Light green, Brooks Light now, looking to center. Lost his footing, Green steps up and snapped the shot right on.
And I promise I'll get Steve Abitroni's game story in tomorrow in Anaheim.
There's Light working the boards. Matt Bradley fires right on. Rebound collected by Briere. As now the top flyer line hemmed in. This is a rare shift where they haven't been able to get out of their own zone.
8-3 the shots for Washington. All Washington in the third.
And look who's behind the net. Mike Green. Fleischmann plays it across. There's Light. Fleischmann camped in front. Pass doesn't arrive. Off the glass. Ryan Parent can't clear it. Fleischmann chipped it. Now it's out. But driven right back in by Sean Morrison. Less than 5 minutes left.
Playoff game. 4-4. And Mike Green is behind Philadelphia's net with 4 minutes left to go.
And you said Green means go up. A shot. Ovechkin scores! There it is! His first Stanley Cup playoff goal! And it's a go-ahead goal for Washington!
Only a matter of time. You can't cover this guy for 60 minutes. Full control, Philadelphia. Panic merchant. There's the panic threshold. Kukkonen cannot play with Ovechkin.
He stripped it from Modry. He took it away from Kukkonen, and he beats Perron.
Perron actually stumbles here. But give Ovechkin full marks. He picked a spot with a sharp cue there.
Great players know how to pick their spots, don't they, Glenn?
Yeah, they do.
Pure magic here in Washington.
What a comeback.
Three in the third.
Oh.
And Alexander Ovechkin with his first ever Stanley Cup playoff goal. Will it be the game winner? Fedorov deep, 4:04 on the clock. Flyers scored three straight in the second, but Washington has three straight in the third. An unassisted goal by Ovechkin, who set up the tire and now has the go-ahead marker. But back come the Flyers. Knubel in front, just out of the reach of Jeff Carter, and chipped out of the zone by Cook. Jason Smith up off Knubel deep. And there's the man, one of the men of the hour, Mike Green, to lug it out.
Should probably get the coach's memo. Trying to stay away from behind the other team's net.
He's deep again, and that was fumbled by Perron, and now they get Green cleared out of there as Umberger takes down the Washington defenseman. Well, his enthusiasm is infectious, and it's ignited this building again.
On the road, you don't get the lineup changes you want. You want to have Thiemann on the ice with Ovechkin. We don't want to have your 5 and 6 on the ice with Ovechkin. And this play creates absolutely out of nothing. And what I love there about Ovechkin, he goes 200 feet down the ice and thanks his goaltender, who had absolutely nothing to do with the play. I think this is a good team.
20th time, Glenn, this year he has scored in the final 10 minutes. And you're right. Everybody wanted to ask him the last few days about winning. Well, he's going to win the Hart Trophy. That's the last thing he wanted to talk about. He had to shut down that conversation and talk about playoffs, talk about team. He hasn't been the best player tonight, but he's made the best play. And now Umberger to work. Philadelphia trying to show their resilience. Can they answer back against this young Cap squad? Kukkonen plays it in. Yurchina back to get it. Umberger in on the forecheck. Cody with a nifty pass, and up they come. Backstrom's got room. Over the line with Ovechkin. Ovechkin fired, and that was off the the side of the post. Well, Ovechkin comes close again. That would have been the final dagger. Less than 2.5 to go. And he's feeling it now. Bumping with Kukkonen. Parent for Lupo. Puck bouncing into the cap zone. Mike Green. They're chanting MVP. There's Backstrom, Kozlov to the net, but the pass doesn't arrive.
MVP, you think? The engraver's already been called.
Glenn, if it's not unanimous, the voters weren't paying attention. Briere. Cody stops that and sends them back. Won't be long till Biron leaves the net now. And the extra attacker comes out. A hit on Prosper by Cook. And an offside is called.
Scouts can measure height, weight, strength, and they can't measure competitiveness. This is Ovechkin on the bench. Greatest player in the game right now. Cheering his team on. He has fire in his soul, this kid. Just loves to compete, loves to score. And if you want to challenge him physically, he'll take you on.
.141 left. Capitals get control off the draw. They've been the dominant team in that area tonight. Cook over the line. Boyd Gordon on his backhand. He just wants to keep it down there. Gets roughed up by Jason Smith, but stays on it. Carter dug it loose. Knubel takes a jolt. Upshaw can't get it deep. The Caps send it right back in. 70 seconds remaining. Now Carter starts out. A move past Steckel. Jeff Carter to the attack. And Steckel with the great back check. Takes it away. Biron has to backtrack. Here's Ovechkin with a minute left. Looking across for Bradley. The Caps will try and hold the puck down deep in Philadelphia territory. Up ahead it goes Colburn. And now Biron goes to the bench. Extra attacker is on. The net is empty. Knocked down at the line. Steckel gets it out. Mike Richards back in for Philadelphia. Half minute left. Along the boards and out. Scott Hartnell's got it. Sends it back in and he'll go after it. Sean Morrison there first. Morrison's put it back against the grain. It comes to Tiedemann. 15 left on the clock. Big hit, Ovechkin, up with it. Washington, Ovechkin just buried Mike Richards. Time running down, Alex Ovechkin has the game winner, and Washington has game one. Some extra activity on the ice as the Flyers in the middle of it. Tom Pony, but the celebration is on here in Washington with the Capitals sea of red. The NHL on TSN is brought to you by Molson Canadian, the true taste of the game. What a night here in Washington. Capitals roar back with 3 in the third, 2 by Mike Green. Ovechkin the winner, and the Capitals win game one. James,